Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the current affairs, that is, best 1000 current affairs of the last 6 months, January to June 2019. This series will be completed in roughly 4 to 5 videos, and if you do this, then definitely you will feel very confident going into any exam that comes after June 2019. This video will be in English language, both written and spoken language will be English. So let's start the video. Please note that these questions have already been covered in my daily current affair videos. However, this is a compilation that will help you for quick revision before you go for your exam. Let's now start the video. Before I begin, you can follow me on social media. I'm available on Facebook and Instagram. And by following me on social media, you will be updated about all the happenings in the world. Day to day, I share a lot of news, views, articles, and also my uploading schedule. Also note that StudyIQ has some of the finest paid courses. Now remember, we have more than 11,000 free videos on YouTube, but we also have a lot of paid videos, and these videos are designed for those people who want to prepare from scratch. If you want to buy any of the course, please visit studyiq.com. We have courses for almost 150 exams. Now we'll begin. Who has become the youngest person to climb the 7 highest peaks and the volcanic summits across all the continents after conquering Antarctica's highest point called Mount Sidley? What is the name of this person? He is the youngest man to do so. He is Satyarup Siddhanta. He is from West Bengal. The government has constituted a 7-member group of ministers to boost the real estate sector under the GST regime. Who is the convener of this group of ministers? This question has already been asked 2-3 times already in the exams in 2019, basically because of the GST, the real estate sector suffered a lot. And to undo this, there is a committee now, 7-member committee headed by Nitin Patel. Nitin Patel is the Deputy Chief Minister of Gujarat. The GST Council has decided to increase the GST registration threshold limit to 1 lakh rupees from 20 lakh. This will help the small enterprises, especially the MSME. Earlier it was 20 lakh, it has been increased now to 40 lakh. So the answer is 40 lakh. One more committee that you need to remember is the Sushil Modi committee. Now Sushil Modi is the Deputy Chief Minister of Bihar. He is also the Finance Minister of Bihar. Sushil Modi committee was set up because a lot of states were saying that because of the GST, there has been a decrease in the revenue, revenue of the state. So GST shortfall, whatever were the concerns, right, to address those, Sushil Modi committee was set up. This is a very important committee. Which state has stopped the Khelo India Youth Games in Pune? First of all, you need to remember Khelo India Games took place in Pune. Every year Haryana is the winner, but this time Maharashtra was the winner. So Maharashtra finished first, Haryana was second, Delhi was a close third. India's sports minister now is Kiran Rijiju. And his constituency is Arunachal West. The Indian Space Research Organization is setting up a Human Space Flight Center in which city? Human Space Flight Center is being set up in the Science City, Tech City, Bengaluru. Bengaluru is the headquarter for ISRO, and Bengaluru also has Indian Institute of Science. ISRO's chairman is K. Sivan. Asutosh Aman, he is a left-arm spin bowler, and he made the record for taking maximum number of wickets in a single season of Ranji Trophy. He broke the record of the great Bishan Singh Bedi. Asutosh Aman is a spin bowler from which state? He is a spin bowler from Bihar. Who has received the first ever Philip Kotler Presidential Award? Philip Kotler is also called the marketing guru. The first ever Philip Kotler Award was given to Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi. These are the other awards which Prime Minister of India Narendra Modi has won in the last 3 to 4 years. He was awarded the highest decoration of Saudi Arabia, which is King Abdul Aziz Sesh Award. Recently, he has been awarded the highest civilian honor of Maldives called Rule of Nisan-i-Zuddin. And Maldives is the first country that Narendra Modi visited after becoming the Prime Minister for the second time. His first foreign visit is Maldives. Remember, when he became the Prime Minister for the first time, his first foreign visit was to Bhutan. So Bhutan was the first overseas country to be visited by Narendra Modi as in the capacity as the Prime Minister of India in his first term, and Maldives is in his second term, the first overseas country. Amir Abdullah Khan Award is Afghanistan. He was given this award by Afghanistan. Grand Collar of the State of Palestine Award was given to Narendra Modi by Palestine. Remember, Narendra Modi is the first Prime Minister to visit Palestine. He is the first Prime Minister to visit Rwanda. He is the first Prime Minister to visit Israel. UN Champions of the Earth Award was given to him for his contribution in the setting up of International Solar Alliance. And UN Champions of Earth Award was also given to Emmanuel Macron, the French president, and also to the Cochin Airport in India, because Cochin Airport in India is the first airport in the world to be lit by solar power. The name of the party of Emmanuel Macron, the French president, is En Marche. Seoul Peace Prize was given to Narendra Modi for his economic policies, Modinomics. Philip Kotler Award again. He also won the Zayed Medal by United Arab Emirates. And he won the highest civilian honor of Russia, called Order of the St. Andrew the Apostle. Name the first Hindu that has been elected to the US Congress and she will run for the president in 2020. She is from Democrat Party. She's a Democrat. So she will challenge Donald Trump. Her name is Tulsi Gabbard. Parliamentarians of the Republic of Macedonia, they voted to change their country's name to what? Macedonia's name is now Republic of North Macedonia. This is to prevent the dispute with Greece, because Greece has a city called Macedonia. So there was always a confusion whether we are talking about the Greece city Macedonia or we are talking about the country Macedonia. So Greece was preventing the entry of Macedonia into NATO. But now Republic of North Macedonia is the new name of Macedonia. So this dispute has ended. Now Macedonia is in Greece and Republic of North Macedonia is a separate country. The capital of Republic of North Macedonia is Skopje, and this is the same country where Mother Teresa was born. And consequently, Republic of North Macedonia has also joined NATO because Greece's objection was over. NATO is headquartered in Brussels, capital of Belgium, and Brussels is also the headquarter of the NATO and European Union both. Who has received the honorary membership of the Sydney Cricket Ground for their contribution to the sport of cricket? Two people have got it, Ravi Shastri and Virat Kohli. So the captain and the coach of the Indian team, they both have been given the honorary citizenship of the Sydney Cricket Ground. The largest cricketing club in the world is the Marylebone Cricket Club. And the first non-British person to become the president of Marylebone Cricket Club is Kumara Sangakkara, the former captain and wicketkeeper of Sri Lanka. Which state has become the first state to grant 10% quota in government jobs and education for economically weaker section? The first state to do so is Gujarat, to give those economically weaker section who belong to upper caste 10% quota. Pradhan Mantri Modi, he launched a commemorative silver coin of rupees 350 and a stamp on the 10th Sikh Guru. Who was the 10th Sikh Guru? He was the last Sikh Guru in the human form. His name was Guru Gobind Singh Ji. And since then, we have had only one Sikh Guru, which is in the form of a book called Guru Granth Sahib. Who is going to head the 7-member committee to look into the revenue shortfall because of the GST? So I told you, GST shortfall committee is the Sushil Modi committee. Which state has launched One Family, One Job scheme? This was launched by Pawan Chamling, the former chief minister of Sikkim. Okay, he lost to Mr. Prem Tamang. So Prem Tamang is the new chief minister of Sikkim. And Pawan Chamling, he was the CM for 27 years, which is a record in India. He broke the record of Jyoti Basu. So Sikkim's capital is Gangtok, and Sikkim started One Family, One Job scheme. Remember, Prem Tamang is also called P.S. Gole. He has another name called P.S. Gole. So in the option, sometimes you may see the word Prem Tamang, sometimes P.S. Gole. His party is Sikkim Krantikari Morcha. This party came to being. This party was started in 2013. Private bank IDFC, it has changed its name to what? So IDFC Bank has merged with Capital First. Okay, Capital First. Therefore, the new name is IDFC First. So the answer is IDFC First Bank. The Army Day was celebrated on January the 15th all across country. Why is Army Day celebrated? Because on this day, K.M. Kariappa, he became the first commander-in-chief. He became the first Indian commander-in-chief. Because early before him, the command of the Indian Army was in the hands of the British. So this happened in 1949. So it was the 71st Army Day. Which state's traffic police, they have started a road safety robot called Rodeo. This is for traffic management and road safety. Rodeo has been started by Chennai police, so the answer is Tamil Nadu. Who has become the youngest gold medal winner in the Khelo India Youth Game? Khelo India Youth Game, Maharashtra finished first and Haryana finished second. The youngest gold medalist was only 10 years old. He is a shooter. He is Abhinav Shaw. Which team has won the Premier Badminton League? Premier Badminton League this time was won by Bengaluru Raptors. Nitin Gadkari, he is the minister for road development, road transport. He has released the inaugural issue of which monthly magazine of the Ministry for Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. This ministry no longer exists. It has been replaced by the Ministry of Jal Shakti. And Jal Shakti Minister now is Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. His Lok Sabha constituency is Jodhpur. So the monthly magazine of Jal Shakti Mantralaya will be now Jal Charcha. Yellow Vest protest. They are happening in which country? They happened in which country? Yellow Vest protests are because of the increasing prices of fuel and increasing prices of the lifestyle, materials, commodities, goods and services. These are taking place in France. Ama Ghare LED, which means LED in my home. Ama Ghare LED is a scheme launched by which state? According to this scheme, 4 free LED bulbs will be provided to each home, capacity of 9 watt. This has been started by Odisha. There are 6 states in India which have signed multi-purpose Renukaji Dam project. Renukaji Dam project, which of the following states is not one of those? UP is there, Haryana is there, Himachal is there, MP is not a part of Renukaji Dam project. So which are the states which are a part of it? Haryana, Himachal, Uttarakhand, Delhi, Rajasthan and UP, Uttar Pradesh. And under the Renukaji Dam project, multi-purpose project, there are 3 sub-projects. So first we have the Lakhwar project, which is on Yamuna River in Uttarakhand. Then we have the Kisau project, which is on the Tons River in Uttarakhand. And then we have the Renukaji project on Giri River in Himachal. So there are 3 sub-projects under Renukaji project. Lakhwar project on Yamuna River in Uttarakhand. Kisau project on the Tons River, which is in Uttarakhand and Himachal. And we have a Renukaji project on the Giri River in Himachal. The cabinet has approved the establishment of 2 more All India Institute of Medical Science in which state? So 2 aims are coming up, one in Samba and one in Pulwama in Jammu and Kashmir. So Jammu, Kashmir, Samba and Pulwama will have AIMS, All India Institute of Medical Science. Remember, there is the 3rd AIMS that will be set up in Rajkot in Gujarat. And there will be 2 more that have been announced. One in Madurai in Tamil Nadu and one in Bibi Nagar in Telangana. What is the rank of India in the Economist's Democracy Index? Norway is the world's best democracy according to the Economist Intelligence Unit. India is at a 41 position. The government has announced the National Clean Air Program in how many cities of India? National Clean Air Program was announced in 102 most polluted cities of India. Remember the target. The target of National Clean Air Program is to reduce the PM2.5 and PM10, that is the particulate matter concentration, by 20 to 30% by 2024. India's longest 300 meter single lane steel cable suspension bridge was inaugurated in which state? It was inaugurated in Arunachal Pradesh. Where? In Upper Siang district on the Siang River, and the bridge is called Payorang Bridge. So I repeat once more, India's longest 300 meter single lane steel cable suspension bridge is called Payorang Bridge, inaugurated on Siang River in Upper Siang district of Arunachal Pradesh. One more bridge has been inaugurated in Arunachal Pradesh, which is called Difo Bridge. Difo Bridge. Who has been named the chef de mission for the 2020 Tokyo Olympic? Chef de mission is nothing but the manager, and he is Birendra Prasad Baishya. Birendra Prasad Baishya. Tokyo Olympics will be in 2020. Then in 2024, we will have the Paris Olympics. In 2028, we will have the Los Angeles Olympics in America. If I talk about the Winter Olympics, then in 2018, we had the Winter Olympics in Pyeongchang. Clear? Only 2 Indians participated in the Winter Olympics. Jagdish Singh, he is a skier, he does ski, and Shiva Keshwan. Shiva Keshwan was also the flag bearer in the opening ceremony. His sport is luge. The next Winter Olympics will be in 2022. And they will take place in Beijing, capital of China. And in 2026, Winter Olympics will take place in Italy in 2 cities, Milan and Cortina. Who has become the first Indian to head the Global Solar Council? Global Solar Council, first Indian to head it is Pranav Mehta. Don't confuse Global Solar Council with International Solar Alliance. Both are different. Which ministry has launched an online campaign called Web Wonder Woman? Web Wonder Woman was started by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Now it is headed by Smriti Irani. Her Lok Sabha constituency is Amethi. She is also the Minister for Textiles. Which two countries got the one-day status by ICC, International Cricket Council? These two countries will now be able to play the one-day games. So these are America and Oman. America and Oman. Why was Oman in news? Because there is a writer from Oman called Joka Alharthi. Joka Alharthi, she has won the Man Booker Prize for 2019 for her book called Celestial Bodies. And Oman's capital is Muscat. India does a military exercise with Oman, which is called Al Naga. And Oman has given a port to India called Dukum Port in the Indian Ocean, DUQM. Who was conferred with the 2018 Confederation of African Footballer Player of the Year? Who is the African Football Player of the Year? His name is Mohamed Salah. He recently won the Champions League with Liverpool. And he is from Egypt. And remember, the Youth Olympics in 2018, they took place in Argentina's capital, Buenos Aires. And in 2022, Youth Olympics will take place in the capital of Senegal, Dakar. Which project has got its place in the Guinness Book of World Record by pouring more than 32,000 cubic meter of concrete non-stop in 24 hours? It is the Polavaram project, which is in Andhra Pradesh. And then we have a Kaleshwaram project, which was recently inaugurated in Telangana. Prime Minister Modi inaugurated the Gangajal project in which of the following cities? Gangajal project was inaugurated in the city of Agra, although Agra is located on the bank of Yamuna River. Who is author of the book We Are Displaced? She is from Pakistan. She is the Nobel Peace Prize winner. Her name is Malala Yousafzai. What is the another name for the Kaisanur forest disease, which spread in Kerala last year? Kaisanur forest disease is also called monkey fever. Reserve Bank of India, they appointed a 5-member committee for digital payments. This is very important. What is the name of the digital payment committee? The purpose of this committee is basically to boost the digital payments in India. It is headed by Nandan Nilekani. Which organization has received Exhibitor of the Year award at the 106th Indian Science Congress? Indian Science Congress took place in Punjab. The Female Science Congress and the Male Science Congress were different. Female one took place in Jalandhar and the male one took place in Fagwada in Punjab. So DRDO, Defense Research Development Organization, won the Exhibitor of the Year. And G. Satish Reddy is the chairman of DRDO. Who has joined International Monetary Fund as chief economist, becoming the first woman to occupy the top IMF post? Her name is Geeta Gopinath. And who is the Director General of IMF? Christine Lagarde from France. Christine Lagarde from France. Odisha has got the license for third airport. Which is the third airport in Odisha? Recently inaugurated, it is Raurkela. Odisha has two airports, Bhubaneswar Airport, which is called the Biju Patnaik Airport. And then there is an airport in Jharsuguda, the Veer Surendra Sai Airport. Government has announced a one-time financial assistance for rare diseases under which scheme? This scheme is called Rashtriya Arogya Nidhi. RAN, Rashtriya Arogya Nidhi. India's new health minister is Dr. Harshvardhan. His Lok Sabha constituency is Chandni Chowk in New Delhi. Who has won the Best Actor Award at the 76th Golden Globe Awards 2019? 76th Golden Globe Award Best Actor is Rami Malek for the movie Bohemian Rhapsody. So these are the 5 awards that you need to remember. Best Picture Drama is Bohemian Rhapsody. Best Picture Musical or Comedy is Green Book. Best Director is Alfonso Cuarón for Roma. And remember, Green Book got the Best Movie Oscar. Best Actress is Glenn Close for The Wife. And Rami Malek won the Best Actor Award for Bohemian Rhapsody. Indonesian company Asia Pulp and Paper Group. It is setting up not just India's but probably the world's largest paper mill in which state? It will be set up in a place called Ramayapatnam. Ramayapatnam is in Prakasam district of Andhra Pradesh. World's largest cricket stadium is coming up in which city? World's largest cricket stadium is coming up in Motera in Ahmedabad. Let's talk about chess. India is one of the powerhouses of chess now. D. Gukesh, he became the second youngest grandmaster in the world and the youngest grandmaster in India. And he became the 60th grandmaster. He is from which state? When we talk about chess, only one state comes to mind, which is Tamil Nadu. Most of the grandmasters, the successful ones, they come from Tamil Nadu. Be it Sashikiran, Vishwanathan Anand, you name it. Recently, R. Pragnananda, D. Gukesh, P. Inian, they are all from Tamil Nadu. And P. Inian has become the 61st Grandmaster from India. So D. Gukesh is the 60th and P. Inian from Tamil Nadu is the 61st Grandmaster. The world chess champion right now is Mr. Magnus Carlsen. He is the world chess champion. He is from Norway. Who is the author of the book Lutyens Maverick? Lutyens Maverick is a book which was written by, you know, Bajan Jay Panda before the election. He is a politician who defected to BJP from BJD. He was earlier Biju Janata Dal MP. He resigned. The party threw him out because he was a rebel. Then he joined BJP. He again lost the elections. Nonetheless, he is a seasoned politician and businessman, Jay Panda, from Odisha. As part of the Mission Shakti scheme, which state has announced interest-free loan of up to 3 lakh rupees for the women's self-help groups? Which state will give up to 3 lakh loan interest-free to the women's self-help groups under Mission Shakti scheme? The state is Odisha. The Ministry of Railways, they have set up a target. They will set up how much capacity megawatt solar power plant by 2020-21. Remember, their target for wind energy is 200 megawatt and their target for solar energy is 1000 megawatt. And what is the target of Government of India for solar power and renewable power both? So by 2030, it is 500 megawatt of renewable energy. By 2022, it is 175 gigawatt of renewable energy. And by 2022, it is 100 gigawatt of solar power. These are the targets of the Government of India. Smriti Irani has inaugurated the Women's Science Congress in which city? Smriti Irani is the Minister for Textiles and for Women and Child Development. Her Lok Sabha constituency is Amethi, so she is a giant slayer. She defeated Rahul Gandhi. And Jalandhar is the city where Indian Science Congress was inaugurated. There are seven big companies in India like Indian Oil Corporation, ONGC and so on. All of these, they have set up a center of excellence in oil, gas and energy in association with which IIT? It is IIT Bombay. IIT Bombay. Prime Minister Modi, he laid down the foundation stone of the Paradweep Hyderabad pipeline project. It will provide the connectivity to which three states? Paradweep is in Odisha. Hyderabad is Telangana, so it will connect Odisha, Andhra and Telangana. So the answer is first. Now there are three banks, three rural banks or Grameen banks which have been merged together by the Government of India. One is the Punjab Grameen Bank, one is the Malwa Grameen Bank, which is the third. The third is the Satluj Grameen Bank. So Punjab, Malwa and Satluj Grameen Bank have been merged into one. The Union Ministry of Human Resource Development, it has approved the establishment of Center for Classical Languages in which state? We have one Center for Classical Languages in Mysuru, which is the biggest one, and a new one will be set up in Tirur. Now Tirur is in Mallappuram district and Mallappuram district is in Kerala. So the answer is Kerala. Our Minister for HRD is Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. His constituency is Haridwar. Who has become the first tycoon to be charged as an offender under the Fugitive Economic Offenders Act? Remember, Fugitive Economic Offenders Bill or Act now will come into play if the offense is more than 100 crore rupees. Clear? Vijay Mallya is the first offender. Pakistan has declared which ancient Hindu religious site as a national heritage? It is called Panj Tirath. Panj Tirath is in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. It holds immense value for the Kashmiri Pandits. So it is now a national heritage. Which state has launched Atal Solar Krishi Pump Yojana? Atal Solar Krishi Pump Yojana has been launched by Maharashtra. This is to encourage the farmer to use the irrigation pumps in their agriculture, which are run by the solar power, named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Which team has won the Season 6 of the Pro Kabaddi title? Pro Kabaddi title Season 6 was won by Bengaluru Bulls and they defeated Gujarat Fortune Giants in the final. Which international airport in Port Blair has been declared as an authorized immigration checkpost for entry into and exit from India? If you want to enter India or exit, it is now an authorized immigration checkpost. It is the Veer Savarkar International Airport in Port Blair, capital of Andaman and Nicobar. Which state has launched Krishak Bandhu scheme? Have you heard about Raitu Bandhu scheme of Telangana? So this scheme is exactly similar to that.
Krishak Bandhu is a scheme by the government of West Bengal. Now remember, there is a scheme started recently called Raitu Bharosa by the government of Andhra Pradesh. Please don't get confused between Raitu Bandhu, Raitu Bharosa and Krishak Bandhu. Which state government has introduced a Gau Kalyan or Cow Welfare Cess? Cess is what you call a sub-tax, you know. So Cow Welfare Cess has been started by the government of UP, where this cess that you pay will be used for cow shelters. Who has been appointed as the Director General of the Ordnance Factory and the Chairman of the Ordnance Factory Board? Both positions have been occupied by Saurabh Kumar. Ordnance Factory is the one that produces your arms and ammunitions. Who has become the fastest batsman to reach 19,000 international runs? When we say fastest batsman, it means in the least number of innings. Only in 399 innings, he has scored 19,000 runs in international cricket. He is the great Virat Kohli. Archaeological Survey of India, it has declared how many monuments as the monuments of national importance in 2018. Total 6 monuments have been declared as the monuments of national importance in 2018. Which are those? So there is the court building, High Court building in Nagpur, Maharashtra. There are 2 Mughal era monuments in Agra. One is called Haveli of Aga Khan and one is called Haveli of Atikana. Then we have the Neem Rana Bauri in Rajasthan's Alwar district. We have the group of temples at Ranipur Jareli in Odisha's Bolangar district. And then we have the Vishnu temple in Pithoragarh district, Uttarakhand. These are the 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Which country ceased to be a member of OPEC? Which country has quit OPEC? It is Qatar. Qatar has quit OPEC. Qatar will host the 2022 FIFA Football World Cup. OPEC is headquartered in the capital of Austria, Vienna. Jair Bolsonaro has become the new president of which country? This is the all-important Brazil. Brazil's capital is Brasilia. And in Brazil 2016, in Rio de Janeiro, the Olympics were held. Summer Olympics. Who has taken charge as the new managing director and CEO of the Axis Bank from 1st of January 2019? He replaced Shikha Sharma. His name is Amitabh Chaudhary. Who has taken charge as the chairman of the Railway Board? Earlier, the chairman of Railway Board was Ashwani Lohani. Now, Ashwani Lohani is the new chairman of Air India. So, the position was vacant, now filled by Vinod Kumar Yadav. So, VK Yadav is the new chairman of the Railway Board. Rajnath Singh has announced a Bodo Museum in which town of Assam? Rajnath Singh is now the Defence Minister of India. His constituency is Lucknow. So, Bodo Museum will be set up in Kokrajhar. The cabinet has approved the merger of Vijaya Bank and Dena Bank with which bank? So, remember the formula BDV. So, Dena Bank and Vijaya Bank will merge with Bank of Baroda. Bank of Baroda. The Reserve Bank has set up an expert committee that will suggest long-term solutions for the economic and financial sustainability of the MSME sector in India. Remember, they will basically try to devise policies which enhance the status of MSME. They promote MSME sector in India. This committee is headed by which person? It is headed by UK Sinha. UK Sinha is a former SEBI chief. Of course, right now the SEBI chief is Ajay Tyagi, Securities and Exchange Board of India. The celebrated cricket coach credited for discovering Sachin Tendulkar, he passed away recently. So who was the coach of Sachin Tendulkar and Vinod Kambli who passed away recently? It is Ramakant Acharekar. Which state government has announced that it will create a spiritual department by merging several existing departments? In Hindi, we call it Adhyatmik Vibhag or spiritual department. It is the government of Madhya Pradesh. So basically, the former chief minister of Madhya Pradesh, Shivraj Singh Chauhan, he started something known as Ministry of Happiness. Now the Ministry of Happiness has been done away with. It has been replaced by spiritual department by the new chief minister, Kamal Nath. Who has been appointed as the new chief information commissioner of India? His name is Sudhir Bhargav. Sudhir Bhargav is the new Chief Information Commissioner of India. Who has become the first ever Indian player to take 20 catches in a test series? He is Rishabh Pant. He is from Uttarakhand. In which of the following Grand Slam tournaments, the heat stress scale was used for the first time? Heat stress scale is basically to decrease the excessive hot temperature in the summers. It was done in Australian Open. Australian Open was won by Novak Djokovic. And recently, French Open was won by Rafael Nadal. Rafael Nadal is from Spain. Novak Djokovic is from Serbia. PM Modi, he let down the foundation stone of which dam project on January the 5th, 2019 from the Chiangki airport ground. And this project has been, this dam is built on North Koyal River. The dam is called Mandal Dam. Which two countries have officially quit UNESCO? UNESCO is headquartered in Paris, and Audrey Azoulay, she is the Director General of UNESCO. So Israel and America, they quit UNESCO. So the answer is A and B. Swachh Sarvekshan 2018, that is the Cleanliness Survey 2018, which is the best capital city in India in solid waste management? Solid waste management, best capital city is Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation, Telangana. Who has become the highest wicket taker in international cricket in 2018? Maximum wickets he took, 78 in all the formats combined, one day test matches and T20. He is Jasprit Bumrah. So the answer is B. Remember, second highest wicket taker was Kagiso Rabada of South Africa. He took 77 wickets. So Jasprit Bumrah just took one wicket more than him. Who has won the prestigious Rachel Hayho Flint Award for the best player of the year as well as the one day player of the year at the ICC Women's Awards? So best player of the year and one day player of the year both is Smriti Mandhana, and she was also on the cover of Cricket Zone. Remember, Cricket Zone is the first magazine in India which is dedicated to women's cricket. And on the cover of that, Smriti Mandhana was there. Tuticorin Airport in Tamil Nadu is which international airport in Tamil Nadu? It is the fifth international airport in Tamil Nadu, the Tuticorin Airport. Integrated checkpost at Morey and the Dolai Thabi Barrage project. It was inaugurated by PM Modi in which state? The state is Manipur, also famous for Sangai festival. Sangai is also the state animal of Manipur. Biren Singh is the chief minister. And Manipur also started a project called School Fangat Hasi, which means go back to village. And recently, go back to village campaign was started by Jammu Kashmir also. Manipur also has Loktak Lake. It has Kibul Lamjau National Park. And Dolai Thabi Barrage project and Morey checkpost were inaugurated by PM Narendra Modi. The Ministry of Human Resource Development, they have made a task force to look into the reasons of suicides reported by which government school? There have been a lot of suicides in the Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, JNVs. So to look into the matter, there is a task force or a committee set up under the chairmanship of Dr. Jitendra Nagpal, who is a clinical psychologist. Arunima Sinha, she is an amputee. She was the first amputee to climb Mount Everest, but two times. She has written an autobiography also called Born Again on the Mountain. She is from UP. Arunima Sinha has become the first woman amputee to climb Mount Vinson, which is the highest peak of which continent? Mount Vinson is the highest peak of Antarctica. It is called Mount Vinson Massif. Which state has launched a web application called Pran Raksha? Pran Raksha web app was inaugurated by the former Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Chandrababu Naidu. It has been launched by the Chittur Police. Rishabh Pant has become the first Indian wicketkeeper to score a test century in Australia. He is from which state? Rishabh Pant is from Uttarakhand. Which ministry has launched the Shreya scheme? Shreya scheme has been launched by the Ministry of Human Resource Development. And what is it? The Shreya scheme stands for the Scheme for Higher Education Youth in Apprenticeship and Skills. Basically, skill development and apprenticeship for the youth. Prime Minister Modi, he launched Khelo India Mobile App in which of the following city? Khelo India Mobile App was launched in New Delhi. Remember, the new minister for sports is Kiran Rijiju. His constituency is Arunachal West. Khanej Online, it won government's National E-Governance Award in 2019. It is the online portal of which state? Now remember, E-Governance Award was won by two things. One is Khanej Online portal. It is a portal of Chhattisgarh. So the answer is Chhattisgarh. And the E-Governance Award was also won by the mobile app by the railways called Rail Connect. It is an app by the Indian Railways Catering and Tourism Corporation. Dharmendra Pradhan, he handed over the 100th letter of intent to the compressed biogas entrepreneur under which scheme? The scheme for the promotion of CBG, compressed biogas in India, is SATAT. What does SATAT stands for? Sustainable alternative towards affordable transportation, wherein we are trying to find the new alternatives for petrol, diesel or CNGs in India. Which state has launched the Bangla Siksha portal? Bangla Siksha portal has been launched by the state of West Bengal. And remember one or two more schemes like Sabuj Sathi, where the free bicycles is given to the girls for traveling, and it has won the UN Public Policy Award also. And there is Utkarsh Bangla scheme, Kanyashri Prakal. All of these schemes have been praised by the United Nations in West Bengal. The Reserve Bank has set up a 8 members task force on offshore rupee markets, which will be headed by whom? Offshore rupee markets, there is a 8 member committee headed by Usha Thorat. She is a former deputy governor of the Reserve Bank of India. Remember, there are 4 deputy governors in the Reserve Bank of India alongside a governor. Name the prominent Lingayat seer of the Tumakuru based Siddhaganga Math who passed away at the age of 111 years. He was the saint Shivakumara Swami. Shivakumara Swami. Also remember, Lingayat, they have been denied a minority religion status by the central government. They are followers of Basavanna. In which of the following states, Nirmala Sitharaman inaugurated the Defense Industrial Corridor? Remember, this is the second Defense Industrial Corridor. The first one was inaugurated in Aligarh in UP. And the second one has been inaugurated in Tamil Nadu. It consists of five cities which will be interconnected to increase or upgrade the defense capabilities manufacturing. The Tripura government, they are promoting their own tea. It is the official government of Tripura tea. It is called Tripura tea, right? And the logo was launched by CM Biplab Kumar Dev. This logo features which iconic landmark of Tripura? And you can see this beautiful white building. Which one is it? It is the Nir Mahal. Nir Mahal. And also remember, Rudra Sagar Lake is also in Tripura. So Nir Mahal is the answer. On 21st of January 1972, which three Indian states, they became part of India? They became full-fledged states. Okay. They were a part of India earlier also, but they became full-fledged states. These are Manipur, Meghalaya and Tripura. They all celebrate their statehood day on 21st of January 1972. 21st January every year they celebrate as their statehood day. Andry Rozylena, she has been sworn in as the president of which country? She is a female president of Madagascar. Madagascar's capital is Antananarivo. Which edition of Pravasi Bharatiya Divas was celebrated in Varanasi on January 21st? Remember, Pravasi Bharatiya Divas is on 9th of January every year because this is the date when Mahatma Gandhi returned to India from South Africa. But the celebrations were done on 21st of January this year. This was a change. Okay. The chief guest was Pravin Jagannath. He is the Prime Minister of Mauritius. Okay. It was the 15th Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. And the final celebrations took place in Varanasi. Varanasi is the Lok Sabha constituency of Pradhan Mantri Modi. Government has approved setting up of three naval air squadron in which two states to increase the competency of our navy. Three naval air squadrons will be set up in two states, Tamil Nadu and Gujarat. The Uttar Pradesh cabinet, they have approved the proposal to rename the Mughal Sarai Tehsil after which person? Mughal Sarai Tehsil will be named after Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. And already the Mughal Sarai railway station has been named after Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. Where did the Pradhan Mantri Modi inaugurate the Larsen & Toubro's Howitzer Gun Manufacturing Unit? This is very important because we are promoting Make in India. So L&T will manufacture Howitzer Gun near Surat at a place called Hazira. You might not get the option Surat in the option, so Magab Hazira. Surat is located on the bank of a river called Tapi and Surat is the diamond city of India. Clear? One more. There is a gun called AK-203. There is a factory that has been set up in Amethi to manufacture this gun with the help of Russia. Clear? It is called Automat Kalashnikov gun. Kalashnikov, Automat Kalashnikov 203. The factory is in Amethi and for Howitzer gun, the factory is in Hazira near Surat. Shaurya Award for students were launched by which state? The Shaurya Award will be given in the name of those police officers who have sacrificed their lives to save Haryana. And these awards will be given in the name of police officers to the students. So Shaurya Award was started by the government of Haryana. Manohar Lal Khattar is the Chief Minister of Haryana. India's second Defence Innovation Hub will be set up in which city? Defence Innovation Hub will be set up in Nashik and the first one in Coimbatore. Coimbatore is in Tamil Nadu. It's a big city. So Coimbatore is where the first Defence Innovation Hub was set up and second one in Nashik. M.G. Ramachandran, his 102nd birth anniversary was celebrated and on this occasion, 100 rupee and 5 rupee coin were released. He was the chief minister of which state? He was the great actor and chief minister of Tamil Nadu. He was a Tamil superstar. Now remember, he was the founder of the party called AIADMK, which is right now the ruling party in Tamil Nadu. And the railway station called Chennai Central has now been called MGR Railway Station. Who has become the first Indian and the first Asian batsman to score two double centuries after turning 40 in age? He is more than 40 years old and he has scored two double centuries. He is Wasim Jafar. He plays for Vidarbh. He is also the first player to score 11,000 runs in Ranji Trophy. 14th session of the Conference of the Parties to United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification. It will be hosted by which country? This is supremely important. Both CMS will be hosted by India in Gandhinagar, Gujarat, Convention on Migratory Species, clear? And the Convention to Combat Desertification will also take place in India in New Delhi. There is a mission called School Fagat Hansi. This mission was started by which state? It was started by Manipur, CM Biren Singh, to increase the level of education in the schools. Stephen Lofven, he has become the Prime Minister of which country for the second term? Stephen Lofven has become the Prime Minister of Sweden for second time. Sweden's capital is Stockholm, which also has SIPRI, Stockholm International Peace Research Institute. Which Indian scientist was awarded with the first Sheikh Saud International Prize for Material Research? He is already a winner of Bharat Ratna, the highest civilian award in India. So he is CNR Rao. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, they have decided to expand the capacity of Numaligarh refinery in Assam. Right now the capacity is 3 million metric ton per annum. How much they want to increase it? They want to increase it 3 times, from 3 million to 9 million metric ton per annum. Another refinery that is in Assam is Digboi. Pradhan Mantri Modi, he inaugurated the National Museum of Indian Cinema in which city? It is in Mumbai, the city of movies. Which of the following branches of IIT has launched the full-fledged BTech in Artificial Intelligence? The first IIT in India to launch a full-fledged BTech course in Artificial Intelligence is IIT Hyderabad. Which country will be the focus country at the 9th Hyderabad Literary Festival? The country is China. China was the focus country at the 9th Hyderabad Literary Festival. Nirmala Sitharaman, she inaugurated the Diffo Bridge in which state? Diffo Bridge was inaugurated in Arunachal Pradesh. The Citizenship Amendment Bill, which says that the non-Muslims from Bangladesh, Pakistan and Afghanistan, they can come and they can become Indian citizen provided they have to stay how many years in India? They have to stay 6 years in India. Who has taken over as India's new ambassador to China? India's new ambassador to China will be Vikram Mishri. And India's former foreign secretary S. Jayashankar, he has become the new external affairs minister of India. There is a new district in Tamil Nadu now called Kallakurichi. Which number district is it? So Tamil Nadu now has 33 districts. Remember, this district Kallakurichi has been carved out of Villapuram district. Navy will commission a new airbase called what? The name is INS Kohas. In which area? This is the new airbase in Port Blair, Andaman Nicobar. The government of Arunachal Pradesh, they will construct the Holongi airport in which of the following cities? It's a brand new airport in Arunachal Pradesh and it will come up in Itanagar. IITM Pune, Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, Pune, it has developed a mobile app called what? To give alert regarding any lightning activity. Lightning is also a natural disaster. So the mobile app is called Damini. Telangana government, they have started Sitaram lift irrigation project. It will divert water of which river to three districts of Telangana so that they can get water for irrigation. Sitaram lift irrigation project will divert the water of Godavari river. Okay, Godavari. And Telangana has 33 districts. Name the first transgender woman to become the National General Secretary of any party. She became the General Secretary of All India Mahila Congress. Her name is Apsara Reddy. Indian Space Research Organization, they have launched which initiative for nano satellite development in India? The initiative is called Unnati. And ISRO will take up 7 major missions in the next 10 years. Odisha celebrated the first turtle festival in which city? This is to conserve the olive ridley turtle. It is in Puri. Okay, the person who is a member of parliament from Puri is Pinaki Mishra. And there is a beach in Odisha called Chandrabhag Beach. It became the first beach in India to get the blue flag certification. Pradhan Mantri Modi inaugurated Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Medical Science and Research Institute in which city? Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Institute was inaugurated in Ahmedabad. Dharani. Dharani is a portal which maintains the land records. So it is an integrated land records management system. It has been launched by which state? Dharani portal has been launched by Telangana, and there is a land portal by Andhra also, which is called Bhudar portal. Bhudar portal Andhra, Dharani portal Telangana. Who has become the first Indian athlete to be nominated for Lauria's World Sports Award? She is Vinesh Fogart, wrestler from Haryana. She did not win, but she was nominated. And Laurier's World Sports Award, Sportsman of the Year was Novak Djokovic, tennis player from Serbia. And Sportswoman of the Year is Simone Biles, gymnast from America. Who was conferred with Swami Vivekanand Lifetime Achievement Award? This award was given to Bajrang Lal. Who has become the first woman to trek to Kerala's Agasthyakudam peak? This peak, women were not allowed to enter. It is in Shabarimala, which is in Pathanamthitta district of Kerala. Her name is K. Dhanya Sanal. Which team has become the first cricket team to win 1000 games? 1000 games in cricket, first team to win is Australia. And the first ever cricket match was played between Australia and England. It was a test match in 1877. And the first ever one day match was also played between Australia and England. Who has broken the Kamlesh Mehta's record by winning 9th national table tennis title? Who has become the 9th time national champion in India in table tennis? His name is Sharad Kamal. Mahinder Singh Dhoni, he scored 10,000 runs in one day matches, becoming which Indian cricketer to do so? He is the 5th Indian cricketer to score 10,000 runs after Sachin Tendulkar, Saurav Ganguly, Rahul Dravid and Virat Kohli. Government has flagged off which vans to promote and create awareness among people on the need of oil and gas conservation for the future and the methods. Clear? Basically, these vans will go from village to village and they will tell people not to waste oil and gas. These vans will be called Saksham vans. Who has been appointed as the Director General of Sashastra Seema Bal? It protects our border of Bhutan and Nepal. The new Director General of SSB is Kumar Rajesh Chandra. And SS Deswal is of Indo-Tibetan Border Police Force. Andhra Pradesh's which airport has been inaugurated at Kurnool city? It is the latest airport in Andhra Pradesh at Kurnool. It is the 7th airport of Andhra Pradesh. And don't confuse Kurnool with Kannur. Kerala's latest airport has been inaugurated in Kannur. And Odisha's latest airport has been inaugurated in Jharsuguda, which is now called Veer Surendra Sai Airport. Which state has launched Jai Kisan Rin Mukti Yojana to basically give farm loan waiver to the peasants? Jai Kisan Rin Mukti Yojana was started by the government of Madhya Pradesh. Another Yojana that was started was called Mukhya Mantri Yuva Swabhiman Yojana, where 100 days of work is guaranteed to any urban poor youth. Which country has assumed the chairmanship of G77? G77 is a group of developing countries who basically are on the same page. They present their agenda at the United Nations, you know, together so that it has more say. Egypt was the chairman till now, but now the new chairman is Palestine. Palestine's capital is East Jerusalem. Pradhan Mantri Modi, he dedicated the Kolam bypass to the nation. Remember, Kolam bypass is on National Highway 66. What is the length of the bypass? The bypass length is 13 kilometer. Now, you know that what is Ujjwal Yojana, where the LPG gas cylinder is provided free of cost to the poor people. So, to promote Ujjwal Yojana, now which state government is training 10,000 female? They will call them Ujjwal Didi. Okay, Ujjwal Didi. And these will act as a brand ambassador of the Ujjwal Yojana. This has been done by the government of Odisha. They are training 10,000 rural women as Ujjwal Didi. So they will basically act as a conduit between the user and the government. The government of Madhya Pradesh has launched Mukhya Mantri Yuva Swabhiman Yojana. Okay, it's a new scheme. Now, under this scheme, assured employment of how many days will be provided to the youth that is poor and that is urban poor youth. 100 days of minimum employment per year will be provided, just like Manrega. Which state has approved Khushi scheme, Khushi Yojana, where free sanitary napkin will be provided to school girls from class 6 to class 12? Khushi scheme has been started by the government of Odisha. Who has become the first Indian woman to win Global Future for Nature Award? First Indian woman to win Global Future for Nature Award for conserving environment. Her name is Divya Karnad. The Central Board of Direct Taxes and Chairman is Mr. P.C. Modi. It has made a 4-member committee. The purpose of this 4-member committee is to reduce the number of tax litigation. Who will head this committee? The committee is headed by Sanjeev Sharma. Sikariya Mega Food Park Private Limited, it was inaugurated in a village called Tulakona of which city? It is the first mega food park of Tripura, inaugurated in Agartala at a place called Tulakona village. The name is Sikariya Mega Food Park. The Minister for Food Processing is Harsimrat Kaur Badal and her Lok Sabha constituency is Bhatinda in Punjab. Who has become the first woman to co-pilot the light combat aircraft called Tejas? She is the first woman to co-pilot Tejas. Her name is PV Sindhu, badminton player. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he launched Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi scheme, under which how much amount will be provided to the poor, the small and marginal farmer. Here the word small and marginal farmer means the ones who have land less than 2 hectare. Although remember in the first cabinet meeting, this 2 hectare limit has been revoked. Now all the farmers are eligible for it. 6,000 rupees they will get per year. Waste to Wonder Park was inaugurated in which city? It was inaugurated by Rajnath Singh. Waste to Wonder Park was inaugurated in Delhi. Here from the waste, the solid waste, the wonders of the world have been made, like the Leaning Tower of Pisa, Taj Mahal, Statue of Liberty and so on. India's first AgroMet Forecast Center was inaugurated in which of the following states? AgroMet Forecast Center was inaugurated in Dharwad and Dharwad is in Karnataka. Who has been named as the brand ambassador of Swasth Immunized India? This is to promote vaccination among children. Kareena Kapoor has been made the ambassador for Swasth Immunized India. Also remember Diya Mirza, former Miss Asia Pacific. She was made the brand ambassador. She was made the SDG advocate by United Nations. SDG, Sustainable Development Goals Advocate by UN. Which state's police, they will come up with an anti-drug cell in every school and every college of the state. Anti-drug cell will be made in Uttarakhand's every school and every college. Which state is the first in India to deploy dog squad to check liquor smuggling? They will make use of dogs. The liquor is banned in this state. It is Bihar. Ruling party is Janata Dal United. Chief Minister is Nitish Kumar. There is a dashboard which will give you all the updates about what is happening in railways, Indian railways. What is the name of the dashboard? It was launched by Piyush Goyal, the Minister for Railway. Now he is also the Minister for Commerce and Industry. It is called Rail Drishti. Rail Drishti. Election Commission of India, they launched a mobile app for the Lok Sabha election to report any violation in the Model Code of Conduct. What was the name of the mobile app? It was called C-Vigil. C-Vigil. The Chief Election Commissioner of India is Sunil Arora. Which state launched Sujalam Sufalam Jal Sanchay Abhiyan? This is basically to conserve water and also to store monsoon water. This was done by Gujarat. African cheetah, they will come from which country to India and they will be kept in the Noradehi Wildlife Sanctuary in Madhya Pradesh? This is a very important question. African cheetah will be brought from Namibia to Noradehi Wildlife Sanctuary in Madhya Pradesh. Also remember, there is a lion relocation project where the Asiatic lion from Gir National Park in Gujarat, they will be shifted to Palpur Kuno National Park in Madhya Pradesh. So don't get confused between Noradehi Wildlife Sanctuary and Kuno. By the way, Kuno was a wildlife sanctuary. Now it has been declared as a national park. Prime Minister Modi inaugurated the National War Memorial in which city? This is to pay the tributes to our martyrs, more than 25,000 martyrs. It has been inaugurated in New Delhi. Which team won the first PVL, Pro Volleyball League? Everybody talks about IPL. We should talk about Pro Volleyball League also because it was very successfully conducted. It was won by Chennai Spartans and they defeated Calicut Heroes in the final. Reserve Bank of India, they have done a $75 billion swap agreement with which bank? They have done it with Bank of Japan to reduce the instability in the rupee dollar and also to make the rupee more stable. Bank of Japan. Cobra Gold, one of the biggest military exercises of the world in which a lot of countries participated, where was it conducted? Cobra Gold was conducted in Thailand. Thailand's capital is Bangkok. India does a military exercise with Thailand called Maitri. Which movie won the Oscar? Best film. You have to remember only three awards. Best film, best actor, best actress. That's it. Best film is Green Book. And best actress was won by Olivia Colman for the movie The Favourite. And best actor was won by Rami Malek for the movie Bohemian Rhapsody. Bohemian Rhapsody. Suresh Prabhu, he inaugurated National Institute of Design in which two cities? There are four National Institute of Design that are coming up. One in Bhopal, one in Jorhat, one in Kurukshetra, Haryana, and the fourth one in Amravati, Andhra Pradesh. These are the absolutely four new National Institute of Design. Bhopal, Jorhat, Kurukshetra, Amravati. So the answer is Bhopal and Jorhat. It has already been inaugurated by Suresh Prabhu. He is a former Minister of Civil Aviation and Commerce. Now the Commerce Minister is Piyush Goyal and now Civil Aviation Minister is Hardeep Singh Puri. Who has become the first bowler in T20 history to take 4 wickets in 4 balls? It was done by Rashid Khan of Afghanistan. He took 4 wickets in 4 balls. Who was conferred the Gandhi Peace Prize for 2018 by President Ramnath Kovind? For 2018, it was given to Yohei Sasakawa for doing exceptional work for eradicating leprosy. Now for 2015, it was given to Vivekanand Organization. It is in Kanyakumari. Vivekanand Kendra Kanyakumari for rural development. For 2016, it was given to not one but two organizations. One is Akshay Patra, which provides midday meals to children. And then we have Sulabh International, which removes manual scavenging. Sulabh International was founded by Dr. Bindeshwar Pathak. And for 2017, it was given to Ekal Abhiyan Trust. A joint military exercise called Sampriti 2019. It was held between India and which of the following countries? Sampriti took place between India and Bangladesh. Where was the Titanwala Museum inaugurated by the Textile Minister Smriti Irani, who is now the Minister for Textile and also for Women and Child Development? Her Lok Sabha constituency is Amethi, from where she defeated Rahul Gandhi. Titanwala Museum was inaugurated in Rajasthan at a place called Bagadu, which is very near to Jaipur. Okay, and remember, it is famous for wood block paintings on cloth. Okay, and this is done by a community called Chippa community. Who has become the first Indian to score 8,000 runs in T20? First Indian cricketer to score 8,000 runs in T20 is Suresh Raina. United Nations has complimented which state's chief for his government's proposal of 33% reservation in Parliament and Legislative Assembly. This state is the first one to give reservation to women 33% in the MLA election and the MP, that is Lok Sabha and Legislative Assembly election. It is Odisha. Naveen Patnaik is the chief minister. Ruling party is called Biju Janata Dal. Nitin Gadkari, he inaugurated a 1210 meter long bridge over which river in Jammu Kashmir recently. It was inaugurated in Kathua district and the river is Ravi. Which state has declared Pakke Paga Hornbill Festival as the state festival? Although Hornbill Festival is celebrated in Nagaland, but Pakke Paga Hornbill Festival is a festival of Arunachal Pradesh. They declared it as their state festival. So read the question carefully. 3-day Flamingo Festival was held where? Flamingo is a bird that migrates to India. This festival took place at Pulikat Lake, which is in Andhra Pradesh. What is the rank of India in the Global Talent Competitiveness Index? We are far behind at 80 position. Switzerland is number 1, Singapore number 2, America number 3. When did UN celebrate their first ever International Day of Education? Remember, from 2019 onwards, every year, 24th of January will be celebrated as the International Education Day or International Day of Education. If you are traveling to these two countries, now Aadhaar card is sufficient. If your age is less than 15 or more than 65, which two countries? So Aadhaar card is a valid travel document now for Nepal and Bhutan. For Nepal and Bhutan. Bhutan's capital is Thimphu, Nepal's is Kathmandu. Who has become the first woman IPS officer to complete South Pole expedition? South Pole is the southernmost point of Antarctica and temperature is like minus 50, minus 60. So it was very difficult. But first woman to do it is Aparna Kumar. Which player won the ICC Cricketer of the Year, for which the trophy that is given is called Sir Garfield Sobers Trophy? Sir Garfield Sobers was a great left-handed batsman of West Indies, after which the trophy name is kept. And he won the Men's Test Player of the Year and also ICC One Day Player of the Year. All the three awards he won. He is Virat Kohli. This has happened for the first time, that One Day Player of the Year, Test Player of the Year and Overall Player of the Year is one player. Also remember Rishabh Pant. He won the ICC's Emerging Cricketer of the Year. Who led the all-women contingent of the Assam Rifles on Republic Day? Assam Rifles is the oldest paramilitary force of India and this time it participated in the Republic Day. It was the 70th Republic Day and it participated for the first time. Clear? Major Khushbu Kanwar was the leader. Which city has been named as the World Capital of Architecture for 2020 by UNESCO? They have declared it for the first time. The city is Rio de Janeiro. The last Olympic Games took place in 2016 in Rio de Janeiro. Olympic Games will take place in 2020 next year in Tokyo, 2024 Paris, 2028 in Los Angeles in America. Which company has launched a e-commerce platform called Reweave.in? This is called Project Reweave. Basically, they want to help the handloom weavers sell their products online. Project Reweave or Reweave.in has been started by Microsoft. Who was bestowed with Sansad Ratan Award for distinguished performance as a parliamentarian? Sansad Ratan Award was started in 2010 and the person who has won it is Anurag Thakur. Anurag Thakur has won the Sansad Ratan Award, distinguished parliamentarian. Madhu Babu Pension Yojana is a scheme of which state? Madhu Babu Pension Yojana is a scheme which has started by the government of Odisha. This is to provide pension to the disabled and to the senior citizen. Prime Minister Modi, he launched this mobile app called MAROGYA. It is a healthcare mobile app, MAROGYA, in which state or union territory? It was launched in Dadra Nagar Haveli. MAROGYA is a mobile app of Dadra and Nagar Haveli. India's new health minister is Dr. Harshvardhan. His Lok Sabha constituency is Chandni Chowk. The government has decided to induct how much percent of women in military police? Out of all the military police that is there in India, 20% will be now women. Which cricketer has been named as the brand ambassador for Rajasthan Royals for the IPL 2019? Who was he? He is Shane Warne. If you remember, IPL won, the first season of IPL was won by Rajasthan Royals in the stewardship of Shane Warne. He was the captain. And his autobiography is called No Spin, which was launched in 2019. IPL was won by Mumbai Indians. They defeated Chennai Super Kings in the final. The government has launched Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana, PYSYM, okay, Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana. Under this scheme, each subscriber will receive minimum assured pension of how much per month after attaining the age of 60 years. So, every subscriber who has subscribed to this scheme will receive 3000 rupees per month after attaining age of 60 years. Anyone who attains the age of 60 years is called a senior citizen. NASA's Mars rover. Okay, rover is nothing but it is a space shuttle or a spacecraft. It is called Opportunity. The Opportunity was the name of the Mars rover of NASA. It was officially declared dead after having contributed to almost how many years of grant services. It was able to give photographs of Mars from time to time for 15 years. It served for 15 years. Cabinet has approved allotment of land to Pasteur Institute for establishing new viral vaccine manufacturing unit in which state? It has been done in Kunnur, which is in Tamil Nadu. So in Tamil Nadu, we have something known as Pasteur Institute, and there will be manufactured or established. We will manufacture the viral vaccine and we will set up new viral vaccine manufacturing unit. The World Sustainable Development Summit. Remember, it is the main event of TERI, the Energy and Research Institute. The Energy and Research Institute. It is the main event. World Sustainable Development Summit was inaugurated by Vice President Venkaiah Naidu in which city? It was conducted in Delhi. And there are 17 Sustainable Development Goals, which we have to realize by 2030. Who has been conferred Tagore Award for Cultural Harmony for the year 2016? For 2016, it is given to Ram Sutar Vanji. He is the architect of Statue of Unity in Gujarat. 182 meter, highest statue in the world. Ram Sutar Vanji. But if they ask 2014 and 2015, these were also announced recently. So you have to remember all the three. For 2014, it was given to famous dancer Rajkumar Singhjeet Singh. For 2015, it was given to Bangladesh cultural organization called Chaya Knot. And for 2016, given to Ram Sutar Vanji. He is an architect, a sculptor. Inland Waterways Authority of India has launched which portal for real-time information on available depth on stretches of national waterway? So basically, if a ship is going in these waterways or a boat or a ferry or a ro-ro or a jetty, they will get to know the depth of the river on real-time basis. Clear? This software is called LADIS. And remember, total there are 111 national waterways in India. Earlier, there were only 506 new will be set up, so total 111. And what is the full form of LADIS? It stands for Least Available Depth Information System. India's first AgroMet Forecast Center was inaugurated in which of the following states? AgroMet Forecast Center was inaugurated in Dharwad. And Dharwad is in Karnataka, so the answer is Karnataka. And who is India's new agriculture minister? India's new agriculture minister is... Now you tell me, okay, you write down the name in comments, and if possible tell me the constituency also. Okay, let me give you a hint. He is also the minister for rural development. Pahari Dam Modernization Project. It was inaugurated by Pradhan Mantri Modi in which of the following states? Pahari Dam is located in Madhya Pradesh. Clear? And it was inaugurated by Pradhan Mantri Modi in Jhansi. Jhansi is in UP, but Pahari Dam is in Madhya Pradesh. Now remember, this dam is built over the river Dhasan. Dhasan is a tributary of Chambal River, and Chambal River originates from Madhya Pradesh. That is why the answer is Madhya Pradesh. First district cooling system of India. It will come up in which of the following city? It is to basically keep the city cool. First district cooling system will come up in Amaravati, the new capital of Andhra Pradesh. There is a banned poem. It is written in Punjabi. It is a poem about Jallianwala massacre called Khuni Baisakhi. Now, Khuni Baisakhi poem is being published in English now in UK. So, who was the writer of this historic poem? Khuni Baisakhi was written by Nanak Singh. Which of the following states has launched the Annadata Sukhi Bhav scheme for farmer, where every farmer will be given 10,000 rupees yearly as a compensation? Annadata Sukhi Bhav scheme is started by the government of Andhra Pradesh. Which bank has launched Nai Disha? Nai Disha in English means new direction program for work-life balance of the employee. Employees, they are often under a lot of stress in the banking jobs. So the bank wants the employees to balance their lives. And the program is called Nai Disha, started by State Bank of India. Chairman is Rajneesh Kumar. Which team won the Irani Cup? Irani Cup is played for cricket. So Irani Cup title for the second time, it was won by Vidarbha. Even the Ranji Trophy this year was won by Vidarbha. In Ranji Trophy final, they defeated Saurashtra. Vidarbha is a team from Maharashtra. The government of Telangana, they have announced two new districts, Narayanpet and Mulugu. So now, total how many districts are in Telangana? When Telangana was formed in 2014, it had 10 districts. Then 21 were added, so it became 31. Now two more added, so it became 33. So the answer is 33. And these were announced recently, very, very recently by the government of Telangana. Their state bird is Palapitta, which is called Indian roller. The state animal is Jinka. Okay, and Andhra's state animal is black buck. Black buck is the state animal of Andhra Pradesh. The state animal is Jinka or the deer. The state tree is Jami Chettu, which is called Prosopsis cinerarea. And the state flower is Tangedu. Now remember, Tangedu flowers are used in the floral festival Batukamma. Batukamma is a very important festival of Telangana. Which state assembly, they have passed the official language amendment bill to make Sanskrit as the second official language in the state. Hindi is the first official language. Sanskrit is the second now in Himachal Pradesh. And remember, it has two capital. First capital is Shimla and Dharamshala is the second capital. Who was awarded the first ever football Ratna? First ever football Ratna was awarded to Sunil Chhatri. Also remember, Baichung Bhutia is from Sikkim and he formed a political party also called Hamro Sikkim. The new Chief Minister of Sikkim is Prem Tamang, also called fondly as P.S. Gole. His party is Sikkim Krantikari Morcha. Who has been appointed as the new brand ambassador of Puma? Puma's brand ambassador is Mary Com. She is also the brand ambassador for BSNL and also for Tribes India. And earlier Virat Kohli was also the brand ambassador of Puma. Argentina has become which number member to sign International Solar Alliance agreement, which means that Argentina has joined International Solar Alliance at what position? 71st member was Japan, 72nd was Argentina, so the answer is 72nd. 73rd was Saudi Arabia and 74th is Bolivia. Total 74 countries have signed the legal agreement of ISA. ISA is headquartered in Gurugram. The Ministry of Labour, they have launched which portal for raising the industrial disputes on pilot basis? To basically have a quick resolution of industrial disputes, the Ministry of Labour has started Samadhan portal. Samadhan. And who is the Labour Minister? Santosh Kumar Gangwar. His Lok Sabha constituency is Bareilly. The Ministry of Commerce and Industry, they have reviewed the definition of startups. Under which entity will be considered as a startup up to a period of how many years? Startup is nothing but it is a new business. If somebody starts a new business, it is called a startup. Now till 10 years, it will be called a startup. Clear? Earlier it was 7 years. So they have increased it to 10 years now. And who is the Commerce Minister of India now? Piyush Goyal. He is now the Minister for Railways, Commerce and Industry. Who was awarded with the Sportsman of the Year Award 2019 at the Laureus World Sports Awards? Sportsman of the Year 2019 is Novak Djokovic because he won the Wimbledon, he won the US Open 2018, and in 2019 he has already won the Australian Open. Novak Djokovic, great player from Serbia. And what about the female? Sportsperson of the year is given to male also and female also. Female is Simone Biles, world champion and gymnast from America. Simone Biles is from America. She is a gymnast, Olympic gold medalist, and so on. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he flagged off the world's first diesel to electric converted locomotive from which city? So basically, the first diesel engine to electric engine conversion took place in Varanasi. 10,000 horsepower. Indian Air Force, they conducted a mega exercise called Vayu Shakti in which state? This is after the Balakot strikes, after the Pulwama attack. The Indian Air Force conducted it in Pokhran in Rajasthan. Pokhran. American President Donald Trump, he is building a wall with which country? This is to prevent the invasion of drugs and criminals which enter from Mexico. So the answer is Mexico. From Mexico, a lot of drugs come into the America. Smriti Rani, she inaugurated. She let down the foundation stone of Hastshilp complex in New Delhi. Handicraft complex. What it will be called? It will be named after Pandit Dindyal Upadhyay. It will be called Din Dayal Antarashtriya Hastshilp Bhavan. So the answer is A. There is a non-government organization NGO from Jharkhand. What is the name of that NGO? It has won the Laureus Sports for Good Award for empowering girls through the sports. The name of the NGO is Yuva. Who has become the first woman president of Astronomical Society of India? First woman president of Astronomical Society of India is G.C. Anupama. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, they started a new scheme called Kusum. This is to inspire the farmer to take up solar power for irrigation. Kusum scheme, what does S stands for in Kusum? So Kusum stands for Kisan. Kisan means farmer. Urja Suraksha, which means energy security. So S stands for Suraksha. Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uthan Maha Abhiyan. Okay, that is the full form of Kusum. So S stands for Suraksha. Prime Minister Modi inaugurated a virtual experimental museum in which of the following cities? Virtual experimental museum has been inaugurated recently in Varanasi at a place called Man Mahal. Man Mahal. And Varanasi is also the Lok Sabha constituency of Pradhan Mantri Modi. India's first full dome 3D digital theater was inaugurated in which city? India's first full dome 3D digital theater, it was inaugurated recently in Kolkata. Which state police has become the first in India to introduce humanoid robot, which means humans, you know, robot which looks like a human being, that is called humanoid robot. It is called KPBot. It was started by Kerala government. International Vision Zero conference was held where? Remember, Vision Zero conference is about healthcare and occupational safety. Occupational safety. It took place in Mumbai in 2019. India's first high-tech forensic lab called National Cyber Forensic Lab was inaugurated where? National Cyber Forensic Lab is India's first high-tech forensic lab inaugurated in a place called Dwarka, which is in Delhi. Government has launched Operation Digital Board. It is launched by the Ministry of HRD. All the normal conventional boards, right, will be replaced by digital boards in all the colleges and schools of India in next how many years? It will be done in next 3 years. India's new HRD minister is Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. He is a Lok Sabha MP from Haridwar in Uttarakhand. Who was awarded with the Seoul Peace Prize? Seoul Peace Prize was given to Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi. Seoul is the capital of South Korea. Which of the following states has launched Sweet Revolution scheme called Meethi Kranti Yojana, wherein the farmers will be taught apiculture and increase in the production of honey? That is why Meethi means sweet. Honey. Okay, Meethi Kranti Yojana started by the government of Jharkhand. Remember, Jharkhand's former CM, he won the elections from Khunti. His name is Arjun Munda. He is the tribal affair minister now. Which country's brown rat called Bramble K. Meloms? Bramble K. Melom is the first mammal to go extinct due to climate change. Where did he stay? He was from Australia in the Great Barrier Reef region. Which of the following politician received the highest award of Spain called Grand Cross of the Order of the Civil Merit? It was given to India's former External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj. Now it is S. Jayashankar. Which of the following telescope has recently discovered 3 lakh new galaxies? It was discovered by LOFAR, LOFAR telescope of NASA. Param Shivai, it was in news recently. What is it? It is a supercomputer established at IIT BHU, Banaras Hindu University. Which state is the first in India to get 2 Coast Guard headquarters? One is Chennai and the second one is Tuticorin. Not one but two Coast Guard headquarters. So two Coast Guard districts are awarded to Tamil Nadu. One in Chennai, one in Tuticorin.
So this was the video. This was the end of the video. And if you like the video, do like, comment, share and subscribe. Also wait for part 2. That will be uploaded in 2 to 3 days. Also, I would like to remind you that StudyIQ has some of the best self-prep material available in the form of pen drive courses. Do check out our website studyiq.com if you want to buy or if you want to inquire about any of the course. Demo videos are also available. See you, take care and God bless.